In this video, we're looking at a projectile motion problem where the height of the landing is greater than the height of the launch. So we're given a water balloon launched at 65 meters per second from ground level. It ultimately lands on top of a building at a height of 35 meters. And in part A, we want the time for the water balloon to land on top of that building. In part B, we're getting the range of the flight, in other words, the horizontal displacement. And then in part C, we want the impact speed when the water balloon hits that building. So like practically all these problems, we begin by breaking the initial velocity into its components. The x component is given by v naught cosine of the angle, in other words, 65 cosine of 50 degrees, and this gives me about 41.8 meters per second. The y component is given by 65 sine of 50 degrees, and this gives about 49.8 meters per second. Now to answer part A, the flight time of the projectile, because we have extra information in the y direction, in other words, we know the landing height, we're going to answer this question with a vertical analysis of the problem. So our y position as a function of time is given by y naught plus v naught yt minus 1/2 gt squared, where g is the magnitude of the acceleration of gravity. We're going to use 9.8 for that. So plugging in our final y value for this flight, that's positive 35 meters. Our initial y value was 0. Provided that we're putting the origin at the starting point for the projectile. V naught y is 49.8, so I have a 49.8 t. And then g, we're using 9.8 for that, and half of that is 4.9, so I have minus 4.9 t squared. Now this is a non-trivial quadratic equation, and it's nice if we rearrange it so the coefficient of the quadratic term is positive. So basically I'm going to move all the terms to the left-hand side here, and I have a 4.9 t squared, minus 49.8 times t plus 35 is equal to 0. Now you may be used to just using a computer utility to solve quadratic equations, but in case your teacher is requiring you to show all the steps of the quadratic formula, I'll go ahead and show that. So t is going to be negative b, that's negative of the linear coefficient, so at 49.8 plus or minus the square root b squared, so 49.8 squared minus 4 times 4.9 times c, that's our constant, 35. And that's all divided by twice a, in other words, twice 4.9, which we already know is 9.8. So we'll go ahead and simplify the square root part of this. And that square root simplifies to 42.36. So we have t is 49.8 plus or minus 42.36, all divided by 9.8. So we get two solutions for t, and I'll talk about why in just a minute. The smaller one is given by subbing in the minus sign. That gives me 0.759 seconds. Then we sub in the plus into three significant digits. That gives me 9.40 seconds. Now we have to ask, which time are we actually interested in here? And it's useful to understand why we got two solutions. So what we plugged into the mathematics was a height of 35 meters. And then we're just trying to find out what time it is when the height is 35 meters. Well, there are two different locations where this occurs. There's the location when the balloon was on its way up. It hit a height of 35 meters at that smaller time of 0.759 seconds. And then when the balloon was on its way down, we hit 35 meters again on the way down. That's when the impact actually occurs. So the larger time is what we want. And we've got our flight time of 9.40 seconds. In part B, we want the range for this flight. And this is actually the simplest part of the problem, and it's because the horizontal motion is so simple for projectile motion. There is no x acceleration, so we write x equals x naught plus v naught x, that's the initial x velocity, times the flight time. Once you have the flight time, this is really quick. My initial position is 0, so all I have to do is take my initial x velocity, that was 41.8 meters per second, and multiply by the time this thing has been flying, that's 9.40 seconds. In other words, this is just distance equals rate times time. That's how simple the motion is in the horizontal direction. When I run the numbers on this to three significant digits, I get 393 meters. Finally, in part C, I want to get the impact speed for the water balloon. So we need to look at the final velocity components when this thing hits the top of the building. Well, the X component is the simple part because that never changes in a projectile flight. So we can just translate that constant X velocity over to the landing point. It's still going to be 41.8 meters per second when this balloon lands. The y velocity actually requires some calculation. So there's our final y velocity component. And how do we find this? We just plug into our formula for the velocity as a function of time when the acceleration is constant. And for projectile motion, our vertical acceleration is just a negative g. So I have vy equals v naught y minus gt. And our v naught y, the initial y component, was 49.8 meters per second. G, again, we're using the approximation 9.8. And the flight time, 9.40 seconds. So we run the numbers on this and get negative 42.3 meters per second. Now that we have the final x and y velocity components, we simply add these vectorially in order to get the final velocity. And that final velocity vector points rightward and downward. And normally we'll just label an angle less than 90 degrees with respect to the horizontal. So that's our below the horizontal direction of the impact. We actually don't need to compute that angle for this problem, but in a lot of questions you do. All we're asked for this time is the magnitude of that impact velocity. That's the speed. And so that's given by the Pythagorean theorem as a square root of 41.8 squared plus 42.3 squared. We get an impact speed of 59.5 meters per second, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.